Take a look around you and see what it is that makes our table such a unique organization. Among us are those who are identified with gold dots. They are women who have joined our table within the last year. Introduce yourself and find out something about them. You'll be astonished at how accomplished they are. But present here also are women who have been active members for more than 3 decades. And today we honor one of them, a woman who has been involved with our table for 35 years and served as president of our board from 1988 to 1990, Frederica Taylor. I think I first had a long conversation with Frederica on a bus trip, which was part of our journey to Crystal Bridges in the year that that opened. She invited me to have lunch with her, and what a memorable experience it was. We went to the cafe at Dover Street Market, and of course for dessert, we made our way through that grand emporium. What struck me was her delight in discovering and sharing a new designer, a gorgeous garment, and how this enthusiasm for what was beautiful carried over into all of the work that she did and to all of the wonderful, generous relationships that she had. Today, you'll hear from a number of people who know her well. We'll start with Nicole Klagsburn, who has a letter to read from Julie Saul, to be followed by Gracie Mansion and then by Meredith Monk. Nicole Klagsburn.
A tribute to Frederica, okay? It has taken close to 25 years of friendship to grasp the breadth of Frederica's life experience, and the stories continue to unfold. And that is because she has the ability to embrace multiple interests, projects, and events simultaneously. She is the ultimate cultural multitasker. Our friendship was first formed when we served on the program committee for our table so many years ago, and was cemented by planning a going away party for Rein van der Lucht, the Dutch cultural attaché in New York. The planning party was hilarious, involving writing lyrics to a song about him. This was one apartment and several grandchildren ago. Frederica's ability to leap fearlessly into any endeavor is enviable. From deciding to become an art dealer after many years of non-profit work, to teaching English in remote parts of China, to many years ago juggling boyfriends from several parts of the world. Even last spring, in the midst of serious treatment, she not only exhibited, but was fully present for the duration at the design fair downtown. Her bravery is only matched by her enthusiasm. Whether a performance, a book, a trip, Frederica has the most open of minds. One only has to look at her eclectic collection of art and design to grasp her Catholic taste. On a personal level, we have shared commercial, intellectual, and physical pursuits for decades, including the sixth floor on West 22nd Street, our book group, and Pilates math classes in her apartment. The founding spirit of our table is truly expressed in the evolution of our relationship from colleagues who met through the organization to Friends for Life, sharing so much together. Julie Saul, January 2018.
It's easy to see why Frederica was chosen to be this year's recipient for the Art Table Leadership Award. She has been a leader in the field since the 1960s. And the breadth of what she has accomplished is astonishing. She's courageous and brave and fearless and strong while being joyful, gentle, nurturing, and just plain loving. She nudged me to always do better and do more. In fact, she brought me into our table, and for which I will always be grateful. I always wondered where she got this inner strength, this love of life, positive attitude, and joy for living. And I found out when I read a recent interview of Frederica by Solange Fabier. Frederica talks about how she lived near a shipyard during the war, and there was constant bombing by the Nazis and the Allied troops. Her father was away, and she and her older brother were alone with her mother. Her mother said to them, "When the windows rattle, you get a candy." They were never afraid, and it was only good when the windows rattled, she said. And this intrepid spirit is in her blood, as is the love of art that she inherited from her parents. When she studied Far Eastern languages at Leiden and later at Yale, and speaks Chinese fluently, by the way, she was drawn to art and architecture. She says, "My professional studies became my hobby, and my hobby, which was the art world, became my profession." In preparation for tonight, I talked to Frederica and tried to get like a rundown of all the things that she had done. I knew a little because early on, she invited me to her apartment, and when I went into her living room, there was Peter Eisenman and like every shining star of the architectural world in her living room. It was an incredible evening. That was in the late 70s when she worked for the Institute of Architecture and Urban Studies. But that was just the beginning. In addition to being the fourth president of Art Table, she was executive director of the Lower Manhattan Cultural Council, director at McDowell, and then Skowhegan. And she also curated a show with Philip Johnson called Destructivist Architecture at MoMA in 1988 that had Frank Gehry, Daniel Libeskind, Rem Koolhaas, Peter Eisenman, Zaha Hadid, Bernard Tsusumi, and the firm of Coop Himmelblau. I mean, when she does something, she does it big time. She also organized exhibitions at the Sculpture Center and at private galleries, including mine. So after all these years in the private sector, out of nowhere, she decides to become a gallerist. It was kind of a wonderful shock for all of us, and a great, great thing. And she opened up TZ Art, which later then morphed into Frederica Taylor Gallery. At the same time as she was doing all this, she was also sat on the board and was involved with Art in General, the Storefront for Art and Architecture, Lower Manhattan Cultural Council, Meredith Monk House Foundation, and Franklin's Furnace Archives. So never a dull moment for Frederica. So after like going over, this is recently, this entire list with me, she sat back, or she, you know, she said to me, "You know, I don't know what my next job will be, but all I know is I don't want to be a volunteer." So thank you, Frederica, for all you've done and been, and for your pure love of art and artists, and for making this art world a better place to be.
Say, I'm happy to be with you, Frederica, because this is for you. So when I think of Frederica, these are the words I think. Elegant, loyal, dauntless, direct, fun-loving, clear-eyed, honest, adventurous, fearless, grounded, brilliant. So I met Frederica in 1981 when she was on my first board, which consisted of my mother, my father, Frederica, and about two other people. We did not have the money for the stamps to send out fundraising letters. It suddenly, everything was in my loft, so at the office, there were three people in my closet, and she was a loyal board member from that time on. And she served two times as president and chairperson, and always kept, somehow we kept the boat afloat, but it was because of Frederica's, not only her effort, but her spirit and her open-heartedness to keep this going somehow. So even when things were very, very hard, when the boat was starting to sink, we always laughed, and that was Frederica, and we somehow figured our way to swim out of the situation. Under her leadership, there were wonderful, imaginative parties and different ways of doing activity. I was thinking of one, we had one benefit where people got on the bus and we went out to Brighton Beach to to a restaurant and we danced, did Russian dancing, drank a lot of vodka, really ate a lot, and just had a wonderful time and got back on the bus. And so we always had, it was always a wonderful spirit. I made pickles for one benefit, my personal pickles to give out as gifts. So that was Frederica's spirit and is Frederica's spirit. I feel like now in this part of her life, she's still growing and her heart is so open. And she's actually getting, she's really getting revelations about life. And her love is even growing more than it ever was. She always had incredibly discriminating insights into people. And she was a very, has always been a very, very good friend of mine. And a very dear and loyal friend, like one of the most important people in my life. I remember one time I have a teeny little house up in East Meredith, New York, believe it or not. And she came to visit me up in the country, and Frederick in the country was also a wonderful thing to experience. Her high spiritedness, and we just laughed a lot over the years and are still laughing. I also was honored to be part of her gallery, and again, this open-heartedness of not saying no to everything. You know, there are the yes people and the no people. The yes people are, yes, you can do it. The no people are, can't do it. She's a yes person. So I was able to do a shrines installation with her and a lithographic edition of music. And she always was so encouraging for my visual work. So I feel like she's a kind of a visionary and of course a real lover of art. And she's given so much to the art world. And for me personally, Frederica, I'm so blessed that you're in my life. And I really love you. Thank you.
Thank you, Gracie and Meredith and Julie. We send our fondest wishes to Frederica. We miss having you here, Frederica, but we are sending a video recording to you along with your award and with lots of love.